Okay, next operation I will explain is how to divide complex numbers. So let's see, if I want to divide, let's say 2 plus 5i, I want to divide that by, let's say, let's just make it 1 plus i, okay? In fact, probably you won't see the problem like this. Maybe you will see the problem written like this, 2 plus 5i over 1 plus i, okay? So how do we actually carry out the division, okay? The thing to do here really is what's similar to what you did before, two sections before this. Remember that I is equal to the square root of negative 1, okay? Remember how before when we had a square root in the denominator, we didn't want that, right? So another way of writing this denominator is really 1 plus the square root of negative 1. And does anybody remember what we did when we had 1 plus a radical? We didn't want that radical in the denominator, so what we did was what? We wanted to kick it out by multiplying this numerator, and I won't repeat, I don't have space, okay? This denominator and numerator by what? If that's a 1 plus square root, the multiplier was a 1, what? Minus, right? Plus became minus, square root of negative 1. Square root of negative 1 here is I, so let's just stick to the I notation. But that's kind of like the motivation for that is because really it's like we have a radical sitting in the denominator. So we kind of rationalize, right? So we rationalize the denominator and multiply by this. There is actually a term for this. For complex numbers, we call this number the conjugate, okay? The conjugate of the complex number sitting in the denominator or your divisor, okay? So if this complex number is 1 plus I, the conjugate is 1 minus I. And maybe I'll give another example. If this is minus, then you multiply by the plus. Same idea as before when you were rationalizing. So let's see. So you do that to the bottom as well as to the top, right? Numerator and denominator both have to be multiplied by 1 minus I. And really, that it just becomes a multiplication problem, right? Okay, this binomial, okay, two terms times two terms, so you can do your FOIL, right? But mainly we're concerned with the denominator, if the denominator becomes a nice, real number, okay? So, and we'll see that in a little bit. So let's do it slowly. Let's do the top ones first. 2 times 1 is 2, right? 2 times negative I is negative 2i. 5i times 1 is plus 5i, right? 5i times negative 1 is negative 5i squared, correct? Okay. Then over here we'll have 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times negative I is negative I. Plus I times 1 is plus I, right? Positive I. Positive I times negative I is negative I squared, okay? And let's try to simplify this answer. So let me see, I'll do it over here. Again, here you have a 5i squared, and then these two, negative 2i plus 5i is going to be plus 3i, right? Negative 5i squared, let's do it slowly. I squared, we said, will become negative 1, right? Okay, so the same thing here. Now notice in the denominator, you have negative I plus I will cancel out each other, right? So that's no more I term. And now then you'll have a minus I squared is negative 1, put in parentheses, okay, minus negative 1. And we like that, no more I in the denominator, okay? Now let's simplify this some more. Hopefully, as you practice this, you'll get faster and you don't have to show me all these steps, okay? You multiply negative 5 and negative 1, that's plus 5. So you'll have 2 plus 3i plus 5 over 1 minus negative 1 is going to be 1 plus 1, right? So you'll get 7 because you can add the real part with the real part. 2 plus 5 is 7 plus 3i all over 2, okay? That's the answer, but probably if you go to the back of the book, you'll see me write my answer as 7 halves plus 3 halves I. In other words, what I want to do is to split the real part from the imaginary part. This is how you usually will see your answers in the back. It has to be in the form A plus BI. Okay, real part plus imaginary part I. Okay, so that's how you do your division of complex numbers. Okay, so maybe I'll give you another example. So next example, if I have, let's say, 5 minus 6i, all right, over, let's say, negative 2 minus, 3i, for instance, okay? So again, we said it's the denominator you're looking at, all right? So because I don't have room, I won't repeat the problem. You just have to figure out what you have to multiply, numerator and denominator. You look at this denominator, which is negative 2 minus 3i, and you say, well, what is the conjugate of this complex number? This is the real part, that's the imaginary part. The imaginary part is negative 3i, right? Okay, with the i. So the conjugate will be what? It will be, you change that negative to a positive. So your multiplier is going to be negative 2 plus 3i for both numerator and denominator, okay? This time around, let's try and not show all the steps, okay? Well, I'll explain and hopefully you guys understand what's happening, all right? So it's really just FOIL for both, right? So 5 times negative 2 is negative 10, right? Then 5 times 3i is 15i. So you distribute the 5 to those two, correct? It's distributive property. Then you grab the negative 6i, distribute to negative 2, so you'll get a plus 12i. Grab the negative 6i, multiply to 3i, you'll get a negative, 18i squared, okay? Now, I squared is negative 1, correct? So remember, I squared is negative 1. So when I have a negative 18i squared, that negative 18 will be multiplied by negative 1. So I can change this negative to positive, okay? So you can do that, all right? You don't have to show me every single step. So I squared is negative 1. That's why this became a positive 18. Okay. Then we do the same for the denominator. This negative 2, you distribute to that negative 2, you'll get what? Positive 4. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Same negative 2, you distribute to 3i. So negative 2 times 3i is negative 6i. So we're done with negative 2, right? Distribute the negative 3i to the negative 2. Negative times negative is positive 6i. So distribute the negative 3i to the positive 3i. You'll get negative 9. I times I is I squared. I squared being negative 1. Negative 9 times negative 1 will become positive 9. Okay? And this is always what we're looking for. Hopefully in the denominator, the I, the imaginary parts, will cancel, and they do, okay? So here you have, let's see, the real with the real is negative 10 plus 18 is 8, right? 15 plus 12 is 27i, right? Combine these two, so you have 8 plus 27i. All over, let's see what's happening below. You have 4 plus 9. 4 plus 9 is 13. And we said we don't leave our answer like this. We separate the real part, which is a over 13. Write it separately. Plus the imaginary part, which is 27 over 13. Put the i. Okay? So that's how you perform the division.